California, a state bountiful in natural resources and rich farmland. For generations, her breathtaking landscape has drawn the very best of people to make their homes here and transform the terrain into fertile crop life. California's farmers produce some of the finest agricultural foods that are enjoyed throughout America and by nations around the globe. But the farmers don't do it alone. They have an ally in their daily challenge to produce these good foods. The aerial applicator. Aerial applicators, some of the nation's finest aviators. Ordinary Americans with the most extraordinary of careers. Agricultural aviation. Charged with the responsibility of helping today's farmers ensure bountiful harvests and sustainability through crop protection. Safeguarding our most valuable resource, the nation's food supplies. What began decades ago using surplus military aircraft has evolved into a highly specialized industry using advanced technology and a skilled workforce. They are truly partners in modern agriculture.
Crop duster in the minds of the public is a guy with a scarf around his neck, drinking whiskey, flying in an open bi-wing, you know, open cockpit bi-wing airplane, which is about as far from the truth as you can get.
In reality, aerial applicators are professional and highly trained at what we do, and with modern aircraft equipped with specialized GPS guidance systems that allow us to be safe and accurate.
Well, I've always considered ourselves as being active environmentalists. Instead of environmental activists. We're out there working with the environment all the time. So, you know, I've raised three kids, I've got grandkids, and I want the environment to be a healthy environment for my grandkids, you know, when they grow up.
Oh, when I look back at my career, my role in agriculture, I feel really good about it. In the United States, we grow more food than we consume, we export a lot, and so I assume that I've helped feed a lot of people.
Yeah, the environment, it's a big issue now. Everything you read or hear on TV, something is about the environment and going green, and you know, that's our concern every day when we're out there working. We're constantly thinking about the impact that we might have if we don't do our job properly.
In California, all aerial applications are regulated by the Department of Pesticide Regulation, whose job is to enforce the pesticide laws that are passed by the California State Legislature, which are based on EPA federal guidelines. Each individual county then monitors and enforces those regulations to ensure compliance in all areas.
My responsibility is to work with growers and the pest control business industry to check for compliance with those laws and regulations regarding the safe and effective use of pesticides. Working with the growers, and now sometimes with second and third generations of the very same families, we've come to establish an understanding of the necessity of the laws and regulations and why it is we do what we do. And really, it's to protect the environment, it's to protect the workers, but more importantly, it's to keep these important tools, pesticides, for the agricultural community so they can produce the produce that we consume every day.
Prior to an application taking place, the crops are inspected by a California certified pest control advisor who determines the pests that are present in the crop, and then the appropriate control measure is taken in the prescription of a crop protection product. The applicator reviews the PCA's recommendation and reviews the product label to ensure compliance with Environmental Protection Agency guidelines, calculating rates of materials to be used, along with checking growers' county restricted materials permits for allowed materials. Sensitive areas are taken into consideration, along with careful study of field maps to guide the applicator in familiarization of the treatment area. And today's applicators also employ the use of specialized satellite imagery, which uplink and integrate with onboard precision GPS units to ensure application accuracy.
When I fly out to a job that's got sensitive areas around it, you always fly out with as much knowledge beforehand as you can get a hold of, you know, what the specific problems are. And then once you get there, you don't just dive in the field and start spraying. You have to go look around, you know, look for obstacles, people, houses, school buses, you know, whatever it is. And then you have to continue that vigilance, you know, throughout the whole job because things change so fast. And you just have to adapt and overcome, or if you have to, you have to stop the application until you can do it safely.
A notice of intent, or NOI, is then completed and provided to county agriculture inspectors, and an application can then take place 24 hours later. All agricultural pilots are commercially licensed by the FAA, as well as the California Department of Pesticide Regulation, to perform aerial application. Ground crews receive mandated pesticide handler training to ensure their own safety, along with public and environmental protection.
Chemistry has evolved dramatically since the days I began when we were using organophosphates. The chemistries that have evolved to this point are many times derived from natural substances, and they're very much more specific to the pest being targeted rather than just broad spectrum.
A lot of the groves that I have are organic groves, and a lot of people think that, well, if it's organic, it's never been sprayed with anything, which is not true. Basically, they're are different pesticides that we have to use. The pesticide can't be a synthetic compound. It could be anything that's naturally mined or extracted from a plant or a bacteria. And any material like that, we typically apply just like other pesticides. Often people in the public will see an aircraft applying a pesticide, and just like a conventional grower, the organic grower needs to control the pests on his grove too. And so when you see that aircraft flying, you may be seeing an organic pesticide being applied to an organic field.
Well, as a mother, I look for the highest quality foods for my family, and most people don't realize that pesticides play a role in our everyday lives. When you think about it, anything that we use to kill bacteria is a pesticide. From hand sanitizers in our children's classrooms, to water being treated to protect us from harmful bacteria, even something as simple as a cut, we treat that with ointments to prevent us from infections. And these are good things that pesticides do for us.
Yeah, we live in a small farming community here in this area, and our neighbors are our friends. And it's obviously in our best interest to use the right amount of pesticides because, you know, we drink this water, we farm on this land, and I live here. So, you know, why you don't want to put your family and your neighbors and your friends into an environment that could be potentially hazardous as well. So, In the recent last few years, pesticides and fertilizers have become very expensive, and you know, we use the bare minimum rate. That's why you know, the USDA, along with the chemical companies, have set the guidelines and have set the recommendations, and we work through our agronomists and nutritionists and other experts in the field, you know, to be as most environmentally sound and also do what's the best for our crops, so that we can achieve maximum profitability and sustainability as well. So
there's a misconception that farmers and agriculture in itself overuse products to grow their crops, and that is not the case. I mean, all farmers' intentions are to minimize the use of supplemental products to grow their crops. It affects the bottom line. The less that they need to grow that crop, the more money they make and become more successful to continue on their businesses.
When we decide to use pesticides, that's the tool of last resort, because they're very expensive and it's a cost if we can avoid, we want to.
All farmers are, of course, in the business of growing crops and maximizing their yields. And a high production agriculture is the stability of a successful farming operation, to be able to produce as many pounds of product off that particular plot of land that they're capable of doing.
It's in an applicator's best interest to protect the bees as, you know, best we can. I mean, it's something that we go out of our way to do.
Bees are real important. You know, the crops need the bees to pollinate.
Well, for beekeepers, springtime is a magic time. And that's the time when the dormant plants are all coming to life and blooming. And sometimes, most times, plants only bloom for a few weeks. So you'll see the little white boxes, either on pallets, four of them together or singly, spread out all around the groves. That means the beekeepers come in at night, distributed the bees about every quarter of a mile. He's getting paid to do that. He'll leave them there for 3 or 4 weeks till the bloom is over, and then he'll move them off. And he'll usually move them to another crop that may be needing the pollination also. Yeah, one of the things most people don't realize about bees is that they are daytime critters. So as soon as the sun gets close to going down, that'll bring the bees home. Much of our work of moving the bees is done at night, because we don't want to leave any behind. Likewise, a lot of the application of products to protect the crops are done after dark, which entails some real skill by the applicators, flying at night to keep the bees from suffering any ill effects.
It's the three entities of the farming community, the beekeepers, and the aerial applicators really try to look after and take care of each other's interests. It's important.
Well, vector control is the application of larvicide to marsh areas to control mosquitoes that are vectors for West Nile virus. By applying larvicide by aerial application, where it's the least intrusive way to apply the materials to the marsh areas without disrupting the wildlife and their nesting areas.
One of the things that we're trying to do is make sure that we're controlling the mosquitoes and having the most minimal effect that we can on the environment and also on the people around us. There was some initial concern that when the helicopters would fly over, there might be some disturbance to the wildlife. But so far, from what we've seen, it's really little or nothing. And even in the few cases where some of the birds flew off, they came back within seconds. So it was really a non-issue.
Applying this material by air, we can apply approximately 2,000 acres in a day versus maybe a month with a crew of ground people to do it. It saves the county money and time. The larvicide is made up of pieces of corn cob or apple chips that are infused with a bacterial spore for Bacillus thuringiensis israelensis, which is specific to mosquito larvae.
It's really better to go after the mosquitoes when they're in the larval stage and they're in the water, because they're more concentrated in the water. You know where they are and you can focus your treatment there. If you wait until the mosquitoes have already come off and become adults, they have wings, they've left the water, they dispersed into the neighborhoods, and there's going to be a bit more of an issue trying to get those things under control, and it may cost actually more money, and there may be more time involved in trying to bring those things into a manageable level. we're really happy with the aerial program. It's worked out in a number of ways. First of all, just in overall efficiency, we've had an easy time controlling the mosquitoes using the helicopter. We're getting better coverage, we feel. We had swamps that were virtually untouchable. We're now getting the mosquitoes down to a much more tolerable level in those areas as well.
Well, in the springtime, it's very busy in Northern California with the rice seeding. We've been aerially applying seed for probably over 60 years now in this area. It's the fastest, most efficient way that we can apply the seed directly to the rice field. There have been other methods that have been tried, but the airplane still remains to be the fastest and most efficient that is available to the farmer. It's one of his most important tools, and he gets more value out of the airplane. When the seed's coming out of the airplane, it's really a neat thing to watch, especially if you're on the ground, if you've never seen it. The seed is hitting the water at over 100 miles an hour. It's really a sight to see. Each time we fill the airplane up, we come into the airstrip, probably doing about 100 miles per hour, and we'll swing the aircraft around as fast as we can. The loaders are on the move. They're running. They've got it timed down to where they can run in there, and that load is dropped within 2 to 3 minutes, and we're out of there. They know what they're doing. That's the name of the game, speed when you're doing rice. You've got to be fast. And it's just a more efficient, fast way to do it. It's clean. Growers can really appreciate us during that time of year when we can get their seed on when they want. And it's just makes you feel good that you're doing something for the community and for the country, for the world, providing a staple such as rice that people can use.
Well, I'm very proud of what I do as an aerial applicator. Being a part of American agriculture for me is it's a very satisfying feeling at the end of the day. And, you know, when it comes to farming, it's one of the last of the noble professions. I mean, they always produce, and they're the last ones in line looking for a handout.
You know, it's farming is a passion. It really takes a lot of desire and a lot of drive to want to do it, because it's not something that comes easily or naturally. It does require a lot of hard work.
They've gone through a lot to bring their fruit to you in a safe manner and safe for the environment. And aerial applicators are their partners in this. They need our help to produce all that good food.
It'd be very difficult to produce the quality and the quantity of crops that are produced without the benefit of aerial application. You know, it's a job that I'm proud to do, and I'm almost ashamed to get paid for it because it's so much fun, but it's okay, I'm glad I get paid for it, because otherwise I couldn't do it.
At the end of the day, people rely on us to do a safe job and protect the environment, whether they know it or not, and it's nothing more important than that.